Good morning, guys. It is Memorial Day, and I got my kids up bright and early because this year we actually have a flagpole. And we're waiting for sunrise, which in Arizona is very early. It's 5:13 this morning. And we're going to follow flag etiquette and raise the flag to full height and then drop it down to half staff until noon. Everybody's excited to be up bright and early. This is one of those things that they'll look back and go, my dad made us get up at 5 o'clock in the morning on Memorial Day. So this is one of those stories you'll be able to tell your kids about how hard your life was.
All right, pull that side. You gotta go quickly up to the top. And there it will stay until noon.
We are getting ready.
Yeah. Which one were you aiming at?
I just looked at it and I just hit it.
You don't even know which one you were aiming at?
No. I just aim at something.
Adelise
is thinking she's pretty tough.
This one's heavy. Mind your Instagram picture.
There, it's been at half staff all morning long. It is now midday. So Denise is gonna raise it to full height. Before midday, it is at half staff to remember the fallen soldiers. And then after midday, it's at full staff to remember those, or the veterans, those that have lived, or those that are currently serving. There it goes, all the way up.
Yay!
Woohoo!
But I have never done this.
So Letty and I went to the store a little while ago to get inner tubes for the kids' bikes because they have had flat tires for a long time. Flat tires are the bane of bikes in Arizona, as you may be able to imagine. And the tubes, they didn't even have like the standard thickness tubes, which are only a few dollars. They only have the thicker ones that are supposedly thorn resistant, which I've never found them to be more thorn resistant. And they were $10 to $12 each, and I didn't want to pay that much since we have four flat tires out there. So what we got was just a good old fashioned patch kit. I'm gonna teach the kids how to patch their own tires and then they can be responsible for them and I won't have to do it anymore. And hopefully, if they're patching their own tires, they will think a little bit more about where they ride their bicycles. Maybe they will stay away from areas where thorns are more prevalent. Right?
We have toys.
Your bike doesn't have flat tires though, huh?
Sometimes.
But not today.
Nope. But right here, I have toys.
In fact, most of the bikes have had flat tires for a couple of months now, or several months now. And so, since Coco's does not, everybody rides Coco's bike. That makes a lot of sense. Huh? Everybody's riding the smallest bike.
Let me show you the easiest way to do this. And you gotta release the brakes by squeezing them and pulling them off back. Probably not the right size.
No. Too big?
Yeah.
My bike tire.
There it is. All right, so we got the tire off. We found the spot that had a hole in it and we put the cement on there with these patch kits. You're supposed to let the cement dry and then put the patch on. A lot of people just put the glue on and put the patch on and then say it doesn't work. But you're supposed to let the glue dry and then put the patch on. And it's contact adhesive, so that should make it stick. So that's where we're at, watching glue dry. Yeah, that's exciting to watch it dry, huh? No pressure. Don't mess up. Okay, push on. Real, real solid. And especially for putting on a new tube, you're not supposed to use tools at all. Because if you use a tire iron or a screwdriver or something, you can poke the new tube or you can pinch the new tube and put new holes in it. So you're not supposed to use tools at all to put the tire back on. Good morning, guys. Go for a little walk out to the garden and turn the water on. Take a little tour. It's been a while since I've taken you out to the garden. So I'll show you the progress we've made. Everything is growing pretty good. These are our carrots. Oops, let me turn the water on here. Okay, water is on. These are carrots. This is okra. These are beans. I don't remember what kind of beans. So these vines grow up and twist around the lattice work there. This one is not grabbing hold of anything. So, let's see. I guess we can wrap it right around this too. And then it'll continue to climb its way up there. That one has not wrapped on anything. These plants, I don't even remember what they are. I thought I had planted green and yellow squash all in this whole row. But here's obviously yellow squash. There's a yellow squash almost ready to pick. But that plant does not look like that plant. The leaves are completely different. So I don't remember what this is. I think it's some kind of squash, but I'm not really sure. This one here has little flowers growing on it. So it's getting ready to fruit. And those flowers do not look like those flowers. Oh, look, there's a bee in there pollinating, doing its job. Good job, bee. Get after it. Well, don't get after me. That one probably is ready to pick. Maybe I'll pick that one this morning. This is a little jalapeno plant that I actually bought as a start. And it's got a couple jalapenos on it. There's one right there. This is lettuce. These are our tomatoes. They're doing well. There's one right there, our aroma tomato. It's got a little spot on it. I'm not sure what that's all about. And then these are, I don't remember what kind of, some big red. Oh, there it is right there. Red beefsteak tomatoes. And there's a lot of them growing. We're gonna have a lot of tomatoes before too long. These four tomato plants I bought as starts. So these tomatoes I started from seed. This one's doing really well. Getting nice and big, nice and strong. We just put these other cattle panels over these tomatoes yesterday. This row, we have a bunch of cucumbers. These are all cucumber plants. A lot of little buds, a lot of flowers, nothing. I haven't seen any even baby cucumbers yet though. I'm gonna rearrange these branches here to go down the row. There we go. Keep them going the direction I want them to go. Those will end up overtaking the whole area. These are watermelons. Got a little bud in there. Keep those going down that way. Morning, fajitas. How you doing? Fajitas really likes alfalfa. This field back here is all alfalfa. And watch this. If I come over here and just grab some of this alfalfa. Come on. She was watching me. She's already gotten up, and she is, you can tell, she's a little excited about it. You want this? You want that? Here you go. Ah, there you go. It's all yours. Enjoy. The ducks we just decided to let out yesterday, so they're going to start to wander. As long as they don't wander into my garden, I'm okay. They wander into the garden, nah, I don't know what's gonna happen. So Hudson, Kira, and I came for a little four-wheeler ride out in the desert behind our house. Letty and the other kids all have dentist appointments. Kira and Hudson and I had ours just a couple of weeks ago. So we came for a little ride and we're out here exploring. There's an old international truck out here in the desert. Some old, I don't know what they are. Tractor, or farm equipment, farm stuff. Old, old, old stuff. Old crane or winch or something. It's got like probably 3/4 inch steel rope all around it. Big old gears. I have no idea what this was. What do you think this was, guys?
Maybe.
Kira thinks we should take this home, fix it up, and it could be Adelise's car. I think it needs a little bit of work.
A little bit. I'm driving it home then. But we still need to add tires.
Yeah, it needs a lot.
What does it say?
International.
Kids went to walk for a walk. And look what they bring home. Then I listen to me.
Snake, and then I was like.
So now I have a princess and
a king.
I'd say a king.
You're not gonna keep that one.
I know. Sad times.
You had to let it go.
Hudson, there's a pale skin down here somewhere.
He's a really fat guy.
Yeah,
he's been healthy.
Wait, did he move?
So many baby bunnies.
It wasn't striking or hissing or anything. So we played with it with the
hook for a few minutes and it wasn't trying to bite at all. So we're like, let's try and pick it up.
Smaller cage. Dang, Alice already chewed the top.
You mean that would freak you out if you
Yeah, exactly.
Out
look at
a big snake under there?
Yeah, that was freaking me out.
All right, guys, just finishing up editing the last video. I figured I'd come out and check our bike tubes. Some of them worked, some of them didn't. Hudson's is still flat. Kira's is flat. Well, that's Nylee's. Kira's is also flat. I guess just the one worked. Only Denacia's worked. So sometimes when you patch a tube, that's how it happens. Sometimes it doesn't seal it completely. Or it could be that there were more holes in the tubes that we didn't find. So we'll have to pull them off and try again. And, I'll make the kids try again this time now that they know how, right? So anyway, this is the end of it. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys have a good week. We'll see you next time.